Hello and welcome everyone, here we are back for some more modern action. Today we are trying out some more Gideon Tribal for Marten. This one's got some interesting tech. We're playing some profane tutors to try and kind of take advantage of the way the deck is built, the way we're playing a bunch of two ofs and stuff like that, trying to just capitalize on that so much. So I've got one path, one blood chief's thirst, some pushes, inquisitions, thoughtsies, endings, and marches. We got one bitter blossom, some knight's whispers, some dams. 2-2 split with a vindicate and Kaya's guile. I'm not sold on that being the best split, but I still think it's better than a bunch of vindicates and only one Kaya's guile. 3 ally of Zendikar, 1 Orzhov usurper, 3 Liliana of the Veils. 3 Gideon of the Trials. We got some purges in the board here, which we got foils of, so we're gonna switch those puppies out. We got Elspeth, Sun's Nemesis. We got a Settle the Wreckage. We got a Wrath of God, which I believe we have a better art for Wrath as well. We do. We got Doomblade, Necromantias. I'm not sold on the Doomblades, though, for the record. I do think they are interesting. Then Orzhov, Ghost Council, Lord of Innistrad, and Wheel of Sun and Moon. We're going to swap these Vindicates out. And, yeah. I want to see if we have another Doomblade art, or if that's the only one we got. No, we got this one. Doomblade's an interesting choice. I'm not sold on it, but I am more than happy to give it a try and see how it goes. Of course, Wrath is nice. Purges are good. Settle the Wreckage seems like it'll be good. I like Elspeth's Sun's Nemesis, but unfortunately, I think this card is just supposed to be the Wandering Emperor. Controversial take, maybe? Maybe? Anyway, then the Necromancy is good. I kind of think I would like some, like, dedicated artifact removal. Some disenchants. Oh, well, I guess we got the marches and prismatic endings for that. We'll see how this goes. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Before we get too far, though, let's go ahead and don't forget how you can support the channel through 3 different ways. Number 3 is Mana Traders. Use the referral link in the description below. Helps you get started signing up and playing your own collection or your own MTGO stuff. It's a lot of fun. It's a nice break from things. Plus, right now, with the way the pandemic is still and everything, there's not much places, I know, for a lot of people to play Magic. So this is a nice holdover until more places become available to do so. Number 2, the paid option. If you want to pay for Patreon, as little as $1 a month will get you your deck played on the channel. We're pretty much exclusively modern, but I'm willing to play other formats. We can talk about it, stuff like that. Yeah. And, of course, last but very much so not least, YouTube. Liking, commenting, sharing, that all helps me a ton, helps spread the video out, get more people to see it. And then, of course, only about 20% of the people that watch my channel are subscribers, according to my most recent analytics. So that means if you guys subscribe, you'll get notifications when a new video is post. Yeah, anyway, we're going to hop around one here, guys. I hope you enjoy the video, and I'll catch you guys in just a minute. For obvious reasons, we got a mulligan. I will keep this, I guess. Yeah, I don't really like it. But we got plays. Ooh, that's what we're playing against, huh? Okay, so a bunch of cycles. We draw. I get the feeling we're in trouble here. Feeling an end of turn violent outburst coming in. Obviously, here we're digging for. Well, damn is exactly what we were digging for, actually. Yep. Obviously, they have Force Negation. We're just dead, but I don't know what else we can do about that, to be honest. We don't have another outburst already. What in the... Uh-oh. Wait. Why'd you return? I'm so confused right now. So you clearly have another, like... another Cascade card in hand, because you got back... the Riverwinder instead of getting back Violent Outburst. So, flying. At this point, we're going to 2 because we're going to take 2 from this. Pretty good system. Yeah, not a single card in my hand here is helping me, so... Damn. Not quite. Close, but no cigar. Alright, so we want Profane out. It's too slow here. Bitter Blossom out. Just again, kind of too slow. Blood Chief Stirs too specific on what it targets. Vindicates aren't my friend here. Need one more cut. Probably ending. Ending's probably the next weakest card. Actually, I think I'd rather have a Vindicate than any endings. I think this is good. I think it's good. Remember, Marten has a 61 card special with his Orzhov Tribal, so yeah. Oh, that's an easy mulligan. I really wish we had. I'm mulliganing again. This is better. Still not great. Obviously, we'd much rather have Wheel of Sun and Moon in hand to accompany these card spells. Why did I say discard that way? Discard. These discard spells. These discard. Fuck, they got grief. Alright, it's fine. Yep. Okay. I'm really doing. Ooh, they have no basics left. That field room was a stone rain. That was even better. They're only playing two basics, huh? Oh, I should wait till their upkeep. It's not even pitch force. Yep. With a pun on my part. Yeah, that was a huge pun on my part. You don't want to turn one of those into a swamp. Okay. Tagging for one. Yeah. Yeah, because of that damn grief in their hand, we might be in trouble. I like to draw on the land before I try to go for either one of these. Okay. How much tin twine? No, I think it's going to end up with them taking Gideon. Oh, they took Dan. Well, it does certainly solve my problem for me. Never mind. We lose because of Architects. There's no way we're going to beat him because of that. Alrighty. On to the next round. Alright. On the play for round two. It's a defensive hand, but I'll keep it. I don't like not having any kind of, like, offensive game plan. Although, notably, being on the play of opponent, it's, like, something against, like, Tron. This hand's actually pretty great. Taking counterspell. There's that. We'll see what they do. If they just don't do anything, I think we're just gonna destroy their land. I think I wanna destroy a land here. Especially because they have, like, spell pierce or something. I'd rather lose the land or the Vindicate than Lily. Okay. Dungo is Goyf, which is nice to see. Right, now you're locked into heating her. Good with me. Draw two. Alright, I mean, I like this hand where we're set up right now. We got Kaya next turn. We're just going to probably get rid of that Goyf and the Bauble. Ooh. Ooh, that worked out perfectly. Never mind, no, it didn't. Interesting. Arctide, okay. That is a problem. Come on, get greedy. Come on, get greedy. Damn. Didn't get greedy. Let's pass. We're gonna take the hit here. Hopefully they'll come after me, not after Kaya. They're gonna kill Kaya, okay. It's not what we wanted, but it's fine, I think. Let's hope they don't have double counterspell, because if they have double counterspell, we're in trouble. It didn't have double counterspell. So we need to get it above 3 so that it survives lightning bolts. Unfortunately, the makeup of their graveyard doesn't mean we can't protect it from unholy heat, unfortunately. All right, we can clear up both those super easily. Of planes and then pass. Yep. All right, on to game two. All right, so I think Profane Tutor. We'll take you guys out. One of the Vindicate then. I actually kind of like Bitter Blossom and Lingering Souls here. Yeah, let's just try that. Alright, I'll keep this. Again, super defensive hand, but... seems fine. Next turn we have access to Doomblade or Dam, whichever one we prefer. Hopefully no dashed monkey coming our way this turn. Okay. All right, we'll see what we gotta do. Please don't have another freaking spell pierce. Let us say, please, please don't have another spell pierce. That would make me very sad if they had those spell pierce. Dragon Rage Channeler. Bolt. Going upstairs. Gideon. Interesting. Down it goes. Look. Yeah. Anytime these decks just get going, it's just, if you're not playing blue also, you just can't compete really well. Yeah, it's a problem. This is what I mean. Like, there's just no keeping up with this. Yep. That's interesting. What the hell are they even looking? Yep. I don't think any of this is good enough. I think we're just dead. I think we're just like super dead, right? Like, Okay. Kill red permanent, but I like it better just how it is. Okay. Okay, let's pass. Consider your options. I actually like this list though, the teamer, like a teamer merc tide. I do like that a lot. I'm gonna hold off a turn. Not gonna do anything just yet. Sure. Okay. Interesting fight they chose to take there. Or rather lack there of a fight they chose to have. I wonder. No spell pierce there. I hate discarding Vindicate, but pushes generically the better card. What enchantment or artifact do we show them that they would want natural stance against? Sorry, natural state. Murktide with Veil protection, I'm sure. Yep. Do they have Veil? I'm glad we got to Vindicate when we did. I don't think that's fucking annoying. Yeah, I think we're a little ways away from that. Yep, I mean, I can't stop you. You're do your thing, opponent. You pretty much got me here with nothing I can do. Alright, on to the final round. Easy mulligan here. This is an awkward keep, but I will keep it. Well, that's super inconvenient. Yeah. Nice top deck opponent. Boop. Yep. Yeah. Oh, this is not looking good. I'm not gonna lingering souls yet. I don't want this dude to draw another card off of this stupid Esper Sentinel. Okay, down to 11. Waiting to see what our opponent does here. Pretty big fuck you. Sack spirit. Yep, to Gideon. Yeah, you can draw your cards, I don't care. I mean, I can trade away most of the board. There we go. We gotta find a way to deal with this Goyf. But we're not in terrible, terrible shape here. Other than the fact that you consider the fact there are 17, 3 cards in hand, and we're pretty much heels against the wall. Let's see. Goyf. I mean, the gods are putting in work here. We're going to one. I mean, it's like drawing a guile of our own here to survive. Okay. I'm gonna keep this way, I think. Problem is, I haven't seen very much of what they're doing. Okay. This isn't pretty, but we got lots of lands, some card draw, and a removal spell. Let's see. Stoneforge. Yep. So I had a feeling they might be playing Stoneforge, but I didn't see any of the signs guaranteeing it last time. Doubling up on Stoneforges, unfortunately, that's a fucking problem. Alright, so we draw another removal spell or another discard spell. You or neither. That fucking hand's a problem. No, they can't ending it until, or if they ending it, then they have to choose to not put into play Batterskull, which probably not a good idea, except it's a turn to kill the Batterskull, or the, like, it's another turn to kill the Stoneforge. Each opponent sacrifices a creature. Make a 1/1. Yeah. think we might be in trouble. Pretty sure they're going to end away my token. Kill trials. Yeah, letting Stoneforge stick around cost us that mismatch. I don't think we can beat this. Because now we're about to be in a bad spot. Even worse odds. Because they have to kill Gideon. They are. Even though I'm pretty sure it's going to lose us the game, because Batterskull kills all Gideons, pretty much. But, I mean, after their first activation, he's usually still big enough to kill them. I guess we'll take another draw step, but I don't know what we could draw to get out of this. Okay, well, we gave it our best try. Overall, I do like the deck a lot. I enjoy it. Profane Tutor never feels good. I don't think this card's worth it. I don't think, like, splitting between Blood Chief's path, I don't think it's all great. If you want paths, play two paths. If you don't, just play three pushes and make this path another one of those two. Honestly, I think this time we just had some rough luck. Definitely wish we had some artifact removal in our sideboard. Besides Vindicate, obviously. Like, Vindicate's a catch-all, but it's a very expensive catch-all. But, yeah, that last game was kind of a sideboarding mishap on my part. But I really thought they were Stoneblade. I would have brought in Vindicate and Doomblade, probably. No, not Doomblade, because they were black. I don't know. Overall, I do like this version. Somewhat. I like the one Bitter Blossom. I don't think we want more than that. Night Whisper's good when it's needed. I don't know what to make the Profane Tutors, but I'd make them something else. Also consider Solitude. Solitude's not a bad option. Honestly, probably turn these three into Solitudes. That's just my opinion. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Marten, I hope this was enjoyable for you. It was a fun deck to play. I really like the Gideon Tribal, although I think we need to change the shell a little more. I think a little more proactive, like Stoneforge Mystic package might be really good. If I have time, I'm going to work on something involving that. If I have time, I'm going to brew something up with like that. Anyway, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you guys next time.